America may lack consensus on a national climate policy and about building a new energy system, but some states and cities are moving ahead with new ideas and new technologies. Call them Laboratories of Low Carbon Living. Here are three examples of communities actively engaged in reducing their carbon footprint. In rural Alaska, trees are harvested from rivers to power biomass boilers, cutting the cost of shipping and diesel, generating local jobs, and keeping dollars in the community.
The community cuts wood and brings it in and everything, so instead of all the money going to the oil companies, it's a community thing now.
Baltimore, Maryland is tapping what some call the fifth fuel, conservation and energy efficiency. Experts think saving energy can cover almost one quarter of U.S. needs by 2030.
We want Patterson Park neighborhood to be the most energy efficient, greenest, most sustainable neighborhood in the city. And by signing this pledge, you join like 120, 130 other people who've already signed.
In their second year, the Baltimore Neighborhood Energy Challenge saved more than 2 million kilowatt hours and nearly 7% on gas and electric bills. In Kansas, America's heartland, the Climate and Energy Project used federal stimulus dollars to fund four prizes of $100,000 to be awarded to the communities that conserve the most energy. That resulted in savings of more than $2 million in 2011, savings that are expected to continue each year for the next decade.
We're looking at energy efficiency and presenting it as a win-win-win because it allows people to save money in their homes, in their churches, in their businesses, in their communities. It allows them to build their local economies because it employs lots of people installing insulation and windows and appliances. And at the same time, it ensures a much more robust and healthy energy future.
But Richard Alley believes that building a clean and sustainable future takes a sustained and national effort.
It took more than 100 years for Schumann's ideas of concentrated solar power to come to scale. It took 30 years for Brazil to develop a national infrastructure for sugarcane ethanol. China needed 6 5-year plans to go from a poor agrarian society to a world leader in clean technology.
And the choices we make today will shape America's energy future. And what happens in China and Chicago, India, and Indiana will shape the planet. The clock is ticking. The longer we ignore what's needed to move forward with non-polluting energy sources, the more it'll cost in cold cash and a warmer planet. Earth's history and solid physics tell us the climate our kids and grandkids could see if we keep burning fossil fuels and releasing the CO2. But all of us are able to make the plans and choices we know will work to discover and develop new ways of powering the planet. For Earth the Operator's Manual, I'm Richard Alley.